Hey guys, I wanted to do a quick tutorial on getting your character posed so that we can have a class photo kind of thing in Mixamo. I think I'm just going to keep it with like a plain background, so I'll use this HDRP scene that we played around with last semester for the cinematics. First thing I'm going to need is my character up on Mixamo, right? And I'm going to pick a pose for them to hold, right? So going through the animations, right? Some of them are just single frame animation like this one. It's just the pose, but you can just get into one of these more advanced animations, right? If you want to have your character doing a dynamic action, right? So let's say I want this like pose here with him coming down on the sword. Maybe it's not quite as interesting from the side as it is from the front. So spend a little time here if you want to do it this way. Your other option, right, is just to grab the hurricane kick, to grab your character rig, and then this is the Gabo, but that's all right. And then just pose your character using the bones, right? Like, okay, this isn't the rigged version. But I could just go straight to posing it through through the rig itself. So if I go grab the imported character model with the bones in it, right? Change my rotation settings, and then I can, you know, make my character do whatever kind of pose I want to have for the class photo, right? Hey, so this is one way to do it, right? Nice, easy way to just pose your character manually. Since they're going to be frozen, that's all good. Once you have them posed, if you use this method, it's quite simple. You just need to control D to duplicate your model. And then if I move the other model out of the way, you know, and I could get rid of the rigged model, then I can see, right, how the statue is going to look. And I don't have my textures hooked up in Maya, but because he is unwrapped, right, I've already done all that. And this is the unwrapped rigged model. All I need to do is then bring the textures in Unity as well. So let's just do the Mixamo method before we go into Unity. I was using, I think, a sword and shield one. This one looked really nice, actually. This back slash. Maybe a dynamic pose, right? And then, obviously, my character has a weapon, so I'm going to include his weapon with him. Now, for this particular one, I guess I could actually use this trim method, right? Could I go to frame 28 and just get one frame out of it? I haven't really done it this way, but worth checking out if this tool works. It's having a bit of a hard time. So we'll just do that part in Maya. Now, we don't necessarily have to get for Unity, but we do need the skin this time. We don't need keyframe information. That doesn't really matter. All right, so now I just need to import this guy, this animation into Maya. Okay, so I've dragged the FBX file into Maya. Now I need to truck along the animation timeline. So if I don't have my time slider showing, I can go there. And then I can view the animation in Maya, right, and pick which frame it is that I want my model to be posed at. So I like this frame here where he's a bit, he's in this pose right there. Now, one thing that I ended up doing with mine is cleaning up the animation pose a little bit because I had some intersection issues. So you might want to still think about posing your character in using this method, right? Even though he is posed, most of his bones are going to be in place. I might want to use S to set a keyframe on certain body parts, right? And get them to line up, you know, where I want them to be. So the other thing I'm going to need in this scene is his sword. But I just want to do a quick pass on him and make sure that there's not, at least not too much of these intersecting points and things, right? Like if he's going to be turning at certain angles, I don't necessarily want to show the problems with the model, right? Like even down here, it's getting a little bit hairy because of the bends. However, same sort of deal. Once I have the keyframe that I want and the pose, I can just Control D to duplicate the model. Again, I could move or just delete the skeleton and then delete the T-pose version. You'll notice that you're not able to move this duplicated version because of the way that they were skinned. And notice that the grayed out manipulator here is reflecting the grayed out boxes in the channel box layer editor, right? So the properties of this character here are locked, which is why it has little gray rectangles here. If they were keyframed, they would be red, right? So if I hit S, they keyframe. If I want to unlock them, let's see if I can do it all at once. I just need to select them all with Shift, right-click, and choose Unlock Selected. Doesn't always seem to take when I do it that way, so maybe just selecting one at a time. Then, if I want to move, I usually want to move the character back to 000 above the grid. Go to Modify Center Pivot to bring it back, and then hold D and hold X and bring the pivot back down to ground level, and generally you want to put it in the center of the grid, but since my character is so large, it doesn't super matter. I guess we'd never set like a default scale for everybody to go by, so we'll all just have to scale the models inside of Unity. But now I'll just export this to Unity just like any other project. So let me get my textures lined up so I can pop this in here. Just remember that you generally want to have your textures in before you get your character model in. So let me go track down some textures. Be right back. Alrighty, so let's pop some textures into folder here. And then I'm going to export from Maya, so I might as well just grab the path directly from Unity this way, right, by right-clicking on the folder, Show in Explorer. That way I can go back to Maya and either use Export Selection or Game Exporter to tell it where to pop that FBX file. Wide stance post or something. FBX file, embed media, we don't super need. It's just going to create a material ball, though, so it doesn't work against us. We don't need skinning, we don't need blend shapes. Smoothing groups is fine. Export selection. Move to origin, I haven't seen that one before. So once I pop it over to Unity, drag him in. Since I didn't have the texture set up in Maya, there's no linkage there. So I'm just going to extract the texture from the prefab since it's sitting right here. Then for the shader type, right, the default is the HDRP lit. Sometimes this has display issues where it doesn't quite look how you expect it to look. Emissive color, metallic, right, no slot for metallic there. So in that case, I like the HDRP Autodesk interactive texture sets seem to give good results. And then here you just have to tick these boxes to tell it to use these different maps. Right, and then add them in like you would normally. Oof. He is very shiny without his metallic map on. There we go. I don't really need ambient occlusion though for an HDRP scene. The HDRP will take care of that. So now I've got a character in my scene. He's all textured, right? He's ready for his photo almost. Last thing I'm just gonna do is add his sword in here, because this particular character has a sword. I could have exported it from Maya. I've done it that way before, but I'll just position it inside of Unity manually. That'll be fine. Okay, so let's bring in the sword files. Drop this in the scene. Kind of eyeball the size here. And then decide how I want to pose it. It's looking pretty good. I don't know if its scale is a bit bigger than it's meant to be, but it's okay. Again, this had embed media, so I can extract the material from the prefab, give it the same material type, HDRP Autodesk Interactive. Color, normal, metallic, roughness, no emission for my particular sword, and I might have to change it to a transparent map because I've got some transparency on the chains here. Let's see if it's going to be happier with a mask map. Opacity. Oh, it is a little bit see-through. You can see the chains in there. I have to put the same in there. Nope, it didn't like that. Set up correctly in my other project, so maybe I just need to look at that one. Troll sword texture base alpha. Maybe It's just I have too many textures floating around. Now for this particular file, it's where I had alpha channel over here. But I'm blanking on which one I used previously for. For my see-through material. Oof, this is really slow. Alpha, base color. Anyhow, then I'm just going to connect the, or parent the sword to the character, right? Let's just say that I've fixed my sword issue. So you guys don't have to watch me fumble with the textures. I'll just go get one that's working already. But this gives me, you know, a completed object that now I could just drag back into my assets area, create a new prefab, and then export this package, right, as a Unity package. That way anybody can with Unity can just download this into their scene, right? So right click, export package, and make sure include dependencies is checked, right? That'll make sure that all of the textures that are hooked up are included in that that Unity package. Alright, so what we'll do is we'll just line up everybody's characters, and I'll try find a, you know, a nice way to position everybody so that everybody's kind of in a line here. So I don't mind if you want to have your character, you know, hovering over the ground slightly if they're a flying character, or they can be like laying on their side, kind of like Malcolm from Jurassic Park, that famous pose, right? Or taking a knee. They could be holding a prop, right? Mostly anything that you like. And then I'll just be dropping them into this scene. And compiling them all. So I'll spend the next hour or so grabbing all of the ones that I have from the web and I start putting them into the scene so we can take a look at them together. Alright, so there's one in there. I think I initially asked you guys to export as FBX and give me the materials and everything. I only later thought, hey, I should just do a Unity package. It's going to make my life a bit easier. So if let's pivot reset on this guy. So if you haven't done this yet, please just get me a Unity package. That'll make my life easier. Plus, that way you could include spell effects, right? I can see on Damon's character here that he might have a spell in his hand. Oops. So, extract. So yeah, if you want to include particle effects, that could work. What else would you put into there? Hopefully nothing too scary. Now this one, I'm not sure if it's going to like this particular texture, because I can see it is, is it maybe a URP? Let's see if it can understand how to use the roughness map. This is the mask. He looks cool to me, but maybe let me know, Damon, if he's not how he's supposed to be looking. Oh, again. Oh. Dylan, what is all this crap? let's see, what do we got here? Oh, he's got all sorts of stuff on him. I hope that doesn't mean 6 textures. Looks like his textures came in all right, so I just need to tell it to use maybe 2-sided textures. And since our scale isn't 100%, I'm just gonna eyeball, you know, how tall I think the characters would be. Jeez, I really don't want to have to deal with 5 textures, guys. Don't make me do it. But yeah, I'll keep putting this together, and now we get the bird. Let's see if she comes in. And you know, hopefully we can get everybody's character up here. That'd be really fun if we can have them all lined up. Right? Maybe we can make an NFT. The LSBU's first NFT with all of the characters in like a 3D scene, right? And then put it into like a picture frame of scene. It's a fun way to do an NFT. So yeah, hopefully you get the gist, guys. I'm gonna take a screenshot so everyone can see where we're headed with this, at least once I've got the last few. This one needs to be posed still. I also need a pose from Nathan. Looks like he might also benefit from like a small particle effect or something that might be cool. Oh, now separate folders. Alright, let's pull them back down. Lambert 4. Alright. I guess we'll try it this way. Oh no, multiple textures, guys. Killing me. Alright, Lambert 1 is there. Oh jeez, they're both Lambert 1. Okay, so that looks like it's kind of working. So yeah, we're getting there. Let's take a screenshot. So hopefully the rest of you guys will drop your characters off soon, and yeah, we can have a really nice 3D class photo. Bye.